The following is a special 1960s radio broadcast extra. Collector's Choice remembers the Sonny Liston versus Cassius Clay heavyweight championship fight. This is a complete 73-minute audio retrospective. ABC's live radio network coverage of Cassius Clay's sixth-round defeat of champion Sonny Liston is broadcast. There are pre-fight interviews and color commentary by Howard Cosell. The outcome predictions of the fight are heard from a dozen sports columnists, all but one predicting a Liston slaughter. The legend of Liston's invincibility is also expressed by former champ Joe Louis to Howard Cosell. Also, comments from heavyweight Liston opponent Marty Marshall, trainer Customato, and from Sonny Liston and Cassius Clay, who states to Cosell that he will KO Liston in round 8. We hear from blow-by-blow commentator Les Kider at ringside, along with Cosell, former heavyweight champion Rocky Marciano, and Jim Brown of the Cleveland Browns. After the upset Clay victory, Cosell interviews Clay and Liston in the ring. Kider interviews Sugar Ray Robinson and Joe Louis. Howard Cosell recaps the fight and interviews Dick Young of the Daily News and Clay's trainer, Angelo Dundee. Cassius Clay is heard live at the news press conference in its entirety. There's a wrap-up with Les Kider and comments from UPI sports editor Leo Peterson. In addition, on the following day, CBS Sports with Frank Gifford is heard. He recounts the fight. There is a brief interview with fight physician Alexander Robbins, who stopped the fight, giving to Cassius Clay his first championship. This radio program was audiotaped when it originally aired live in New York on WABC Radio, February 25th, 1964.
That Clay did changed the press consensus about the probable outcome of this bout. For instance, beginning with Walter Red Smith of the New York Herald Tribune, here is the way they see it.
Liston inside three.
Mel Derslag, Los Angeles Herald Examiner.
Howard, I'm picking Liston, obviously, to win the fight, but I think it could go as far as 8 rounds.
Charlie McCabe, San Francisco Chronicle.
I say Sonny in 6.
Lyle Smith, Detroit Free Press.
Sonny Liston inside of 6.
Frank Gibbons, Cleveland Press.
Well, I would say Sonny Liston in 3 or 4.
Cy Burek, Dayton News.
Howard, I like Liston to win by knockout in 3 rounds.
Al Abrams, Pittsburgh Post-Gazette.
I like Sonny Liston to win by knockout in 3 rounds.
Shirley Povich, Washington Post.
Sonny Liston in a hurry, 2 rounds, 3 at most.
Murray Kempton, New Republic.
Well, I don't know much about the subject, but it seems hard to me to believe that an entertainer can ever beat an athlete, and I don't see this any way that Clay can go more than 6 rounds.
Jack Cuddy, United Press International.
I like Liston within 3 rounds because he's not only a great puncher, but he's one of the most rugged men I ever saw.
Jack Hand, Associated Press.
I think Liston will knock him out in the 3rd round. He says so, and I have to believe him.
Arthur Daly, New York Times.
I can't see the fight lasting any longer than 3 rounds with Liston the winner.
John Carmichael, Chicago Daily News.
I'm going to tell you this thing. If the fight goes past 5 rounds, Clay will win it.
That's the best I can do for you.
So you give Clay a chance?
I certainly do.
You may be the only one.
Well, I tell you, I'd rather be right than president. I have a very little chance of being either.
Thus does the sporting press around this nation establish the Liston legend of invincibility. That legend is buttressed by a great former champion, Joe Louis. Joe, do you see any way that Cassius Clay could beat Sonny Liston?
Yep, he'd take Jim Brown and ring with him. He's ready to hit him a low tackle, you know.
But no other way.
No other way.
How long should it last?
Well, that's all depend on how Liston go about finishing the fight or how he go about, fighting Clay. Because if he's going to go out to play like he went at Patterson, I think it'd be a quick fight.
How good a fighter is Liston? How would he compare, leave yourself out of it, with a Marciano or with some of the others?
I don't think Liston is good enough to fight anybody, including myself.
You think he's that good?
Yeah, he's good enough to fight anybody. I think that this unfortunate is that there are not enough good fighters around today to make Liston prove it just how good he is.
The Liston legend of invincibility. In just a little while, we will be at ringside in Miami Beach for the Liston-Clay fight. And Marty, you hurt Liston, didn't
he? Yes, I did. I hurt him at least 3 times, I know.
Once you broke his jaw?
Once I broke his jaw, I figured that hurt him. In fact, that hurt him for several months.
And, what was the blow?
The blow that broke his jaw was a right cross over a right hand.
Uh-huh. And then in your second fight with him, in the fourth round, you knocked him down.
Yes, right.
What was the blow there?
That blow was a left hook. I slipped the left jab, I pumped the right to the body, and a hook to the head.
Then Liston is human.
He is human.
So Liston, according to Marty Marshall, is human. Marty, are Liston's blows as punishing as they're reputed to be?
Yeah, he have punishing blows, but they're not sharp. So I was asked, was the Satterfield punch as hard as Liston? Well, in that case, I'll have to say that Satterfield's punches was sharper. Therefore, they done more damage.
In other words, Liston doesn't snap his punches. He could be characterized as a thumper.
That's right. A bruiser. He's a bruising type of a fighter. He don't, for instance, he don't seem to be able to take a man out with one punch. He got to throw a variety of them to stop him. But Satterfield, you know, one punch, you're gone.
Do you give Clay any chance at all?
Oh, yeah. I give him a chance. I figure he'll be smart enough to stay away from Liston, to move, I mean, from side to side. If he don't, he'll have to go in three. And if he moves, it'll take Liston at least 7 rounds to catch up with him.
Thank you, Marty.
And if he get in there and move for 7 rounds, I don't see why he can't move the rest of the fight. If he does like Angelo Dundee tells him, we'll have a good show tonight.
Another man who chips away at the Liston legend of invincibility is, oddly enough, Cus D'Amato, the man who used to manage the then heavyweight champion Floyd Patterson. Cus, is there any way that you think that Clay could win this bout?
Yes, I think that Clay has the equipment with which to beat Liston, providing it's used intelligently. Clay has speed and maneuverability. And if he employs an unpredictable strategy in applying the speed and maneuverability, I think he will be able to confuse Liston and frustrate him. And after accomplishing this, be able to hit him the kind of punches that will be necessary to win the fight.
And now, just minutes before we go to ringside, we come to the champion, Sonny Liston. Sonny, what do you suppose, deep inside, Cassius Clay is really thinking about?
I guess he's thinking about the payday he's going to make. That's the only thing I can see he could be thinking about.
Don't you think deep inside he's got to be afraid?
Well, I think he was a little afraid because you ever been in the house when it's dark, when you was a kid or when you was coming up, and you was afraid with nobody in there, but you was scared. And if you didn't talk to yourself or sing loud or something to amuse yourself, you would run out of the house. So now I feel this is Clay's attitude. He feels that if he don't keep talking, he might not show up.
What do you think he'll do when first he steps into the ring, when the gong sounds?
Well, the first thing he better do is duck. But I don't know what he might do. He might jump out of the ring.
People ask all the time, do you think Liston really hates this boy because of the way the boy has talked? Do you?
No, I don't hate him. I don't hate anyone. He's just like a little guy that robs you. He don't hate you. You just got something he wants, and he comes in and tries to take it away from you. But if you can help it, you try to keep him from taking it. Mm-hmm. So, and that's the way I feel about it.
How long do you think it'll last?
Well, I would try to get him within 3 rounds.
And now, literally minutes before the fight, let's go from the champion to the challenger. Cassius, what's going to happen tonight?
I'm going to upset the whole world tonight. Sonny Liston is in trouble. Sonny Liston is scared to death. Today at the weigh-in, he was so nervous, he couldn't even get on the scales. I could see defeat in his eyes. He was wary. He's afraid. That's his gimmick, scaring people at the weigh-ins. But I got him today. Like you said, it's only a few minutes before the fight, and I'm ready to upset the world. My prediction still stands at round 8. If he beats me, I'm still sticking to my prediction. I'm going to kiss his feet. And when I beat him, I expect him to kiss my feet. More people are going to lose their money betting on Sonny.
Seriously, what do you think of the man? Do you think he's a good fighter?
No, Howard, I don't see nothing in him. Floyd Patterson made him look like the world's greatest fighter. Patterson, to me, never was really a fighter. He never really could take a punch. He picked all his opponents. He was a cheese champion. That wasn't a fight with him. That was a rabbit hunt. The people still had that image in the back of their heads, this one-round stuff. But it's not going to happen with me because I'm 6 feet, 3 inches and a half tall. I weigh 218 pounds solid, whereas Floyd Patterson only weighed around 185, 86 or something like that. He was only 5 feet, 11 and a half inches tall. He had no footwork. Footwork means a lot. Watch me say I look just like a heavyweight Sugar Ray. It's hard for me to get hit.
Cassius, are you scared? Really?
No, I'm always nervous. I won't tell a lie. I'm always nervous before a fight. To hear the roar of the crowd and all of the pressure and all of the cameramen and knowing that I have to win after all of the talk I've been doing, I'm always worried, but I'm never scared. And as soon as the first punch is thrown, that's it. I'm all right.
Cassius Clay in a rare moment of candor, and we'll see if he's all right enough against Sonny Liston. That's how it looks from here. Just minutes before the opening bell, this is Howard Cosell. Now here's Les Keiter.
These pre-fight interviews were brought to you by White Owl. Great blend, great price, great choice of shapes for every man's taste. The cigar to switch to when you're switching to cigars.
And now the ABC Radio Network takes you directly to ringside at Convention Hall in Miami Beach.
He's back there in YY. Thank you.
Hi there again, sports fans. This is Les Keiter at Convention Hall ringside in Miami Beach for the World's Heavyweight Championship fight between title holder Sonny Liston and challenger Cassius Clay. In just a few minutes, Louisville's Cassius Marcellus Clay climbs the steps into Miami Beach's 20-foot ring here at Convention Hall to face the target of his constant needle, to run head-on into the devastating punches of the heavyweight champion, Sonny Liston. The man who has been screaming to the heavens that he's the greatest meets his destiny. The awesome Liston, a man cut from the mold of Joe Louis, a champ who rules supreme, who can take a man out with either hand. A ring executioner who has disposed of his opposition in less than a round the last three times he has answered the bell. And now, as sportsdom's most electric moment draws near, despite a cloudy day here in Miami that was expected to help the live gate, Convention Hall will be somewhat less than filled to its 16,000 capacity. And boxing's top experts, the more than 100 boxing writers from all over the globe, here for the title clash, have gone down the line on the champ, giving the challenger no chance at all. Thus, Clay hopes to take a niche in boxing history, alongside Tunney, Walcott, Braddock, and Johansson, underdogs all who defied most of the Sears. Truly, a Clay upset would top them all. We're set for an exciting night here in Convention Hall, Miami Beach.
As Les has already told you, something less than a packed house, but a good crowd nonetheless. We're sitting right at ringside. And as I look at Rocky Marciano, the Hard Rock from Brockton, the retired undefeated heavyweight champion of the world, Rock, they tell us that this ring measures 22 feet from the outside. From the inside, and I don't think I disclose the secret, it looks a little bit like 18 feet. What's your reaction?
Well, it looks mighty big sitting right here below the ropes. Bigger than I ever thought when I was in there. If it helps anybody, and he really needs some help, it's Cassius.
You really think it helps Cassius?
Well, it will if he has a little bit more room to move around side to side, do the crazy things that he does.
Looks a little small for Jimmy Brown, who's at my left, the great number 32 of the Cleveland Browns.
Howard, it does look very small. In fact, I'm very happy that I'm sitting here and not in that very small ring.
All right, we're going to get back to Rocky Marciano and Jimmy Brown. Right now, I'd like to introduce an executive of the Pepsi-Cola Company and probably the greatest fullback in the history of football, from whom you've just heard, Jimmy Brown of the Cleveland Browns. All right, we're going to continue now with Jimmy Brown. Jimmy, they tell me that some of the football players do, that Liston isn't really so big. He weighed in at 218 today. You're at the weigh-in.
Lovateer of the Giants, for instance, is over 260. Does Liston look big to you, who are 232?
To me, Howard, Liston looks like the biggest man in the world. He's a tremendous physical specimen. In fact, I'm very happy that I never took that offer to go into professional boxing. This guy looks tremendous.
An offer that was in the sum of $150,000 for 1 year alone.
That's exactly right, Howard, but I never really considered it seriously at all.
I want to turn, Jimmy, with your permission, to the Hard Rock from Brockton again. Rocky, you've been around a long time. Isn't maybe the best way to fight Liston the way Joe Walcott fought you, moving clockwise to the left, always looking for the Liston right, and maybe faking once and then coming across with your own right after slipping Liston's right?
Yes, and also getting in very close to the big man who likes to throw punches sort of wide. Being in close might be to an advantage. It's too bad that Cassius doesn't know how to fight in close, because I think tonight that would have been the spot to be in.
There are some who say that's exactly the wrong way to fight, Rocky. Don't fight this man in close. He'll thump you to death.
No, Howard. He hits at long range. He hits with a long left jab and a long left hook and a long right hand. It's in close that he hasn't had too much practice with. He hasn't had to fight anybody in close. He's been strong enough to keep him away. But if someone could get in low and in close, I think that would be the way.
You think Cassius is scared? You saw him at the weigh-in.
I really don't know. It's hard to tell just looking at a man. You never really know what he's thinking about. He certainly has not looked nervous. He's been very casual and looks pretty cool. But of course, you really don't know.
To substantiate what Rocky Marciano has just said, and Jimmy, you were there, Cassius Clay just did an extraordinary thing. He sat in this arena and watched his brother Rudolph fight a four-round preliminary, which Rudolph won. And people couldn't believe it, and indeed the doctor came over to examine him again. Took his pulse, determined that it was 64, exactly the same as Liston's. Kind of extraordinary, Jimmy.
Yes, it is, Howard. And knowing Cassius, it's not too extraordinary at all, because this guy is probably the bravest guy I know at this time. He's been around night after night promoting the fight. He doesn't seem to worry about his conditioning, although he's been conditioning very well, but he's been promoting so much, I thought this would stop with this championship fight.
Jimmy Brown of the Cleveland Browns, Rocky Marciano, Les Kiter, and yours truly, Howard Cosell, G. Jessel, Tony Martin, Arthur Godfrey, and so great a one from boxing is Joe Louis, but nobody cares, really. What people want to find out tonight are the fundamental answers to two naked questions. One, can Clay fight, really, anywhere near as well as he can talk? Two, is Liston really a great fighter, or did Patterson only make him look that way? And to talk about Clay for a moment, Rock, Clay keeps snapping the head back, or at least he has in training, to avoid the punch. The reflexes go a little bit when you keep snapping the head back along about the seventh or eighth round, don't they?
Yes, they usually do. But Cassius is sort of like a freak in boxing. He seems to get away with things that nobody else would try. We're taught in the first day we're in a gym not to pull back the head, not to drop the hands, because this could be very dangerous. But Clay has gotten away with it, and he's done very well.
All right, Rocky Marciano again. Now let's pause briefly for station identification.
WABC, New York.
All right, Cassius Clay has just come into the ring. He's wearing white trunks with red stripes down the side. He's jumping up and down, hasn't begun the shadow box yet. And I must say to Jimmy Brown, who's been through some of the big ones in another sport, that the kid does look cool.
He does look very cool, Howard. In fact, I'm very glad to see that serious look on his face. He looked like he's actually ready.
Jimmy, let's quickly cover some of the rules along with Rock that will govern tonight. Presumably, the bout will be a 15 three-minute rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world. 8-ounce gloves will be used. The three-knockdown rule has been waived. No fighter will be saved by the bell. If a fighter is down when the bell rings, the referee will continue his count. If the fighter is not up by the count of 10, the bout is over. The mandatory 8-count will be in effect. You all know what that means. Scoring is on a 10-point must system. The winner of the round gets 10 points. The loser, within the discretion of the referee and the two judges. Handlers will not be allowed to use collodion or any similar drug. No more than four men to be permitted in each corner. right, let's continue now with Rocky as we await the arrival of Cassius Clay, Sonny Liston in the ring. I mentioned Cassius then, Rocky, because the kid now seems quite buoyant. I'm frankly astonished at his demeanor.
Yes, he doesn't look bad at all. He looks like he's full of life and pep. He's jumping up and down. That's a familiar way to loosen up here in the corner, and he's got his back to Sonny Liston's corner.
Over in the corner with Cassius Clay, of course, is expert trainer Angelo Dundee. No shilling here, Rock. Dundee is one of the shrewdest men in boxing.
Yes, yes, he has that reputation. He's been the most active trainer in the country in the last two or three years with quite a number of champions and probably the best stable in the country.
Pastrano, Rodriguez, just to name a couple. And you take those two boys and what he's done with them to the surprise of a lot of people, you've got to figure that his expertise may be the best thing Clay has going for him.
He's got the biggest money maker, too, in Cassius Clay. Say what you will, he really makes money.
Interesting that Liston has not yet begun to approach the ring. And so, the excitement is mounting as we approach the moment of truth here in the ring at Miami Beach Convention Hall. We're back at ringside in Miami Beach Convention Hall. Yours truly, Howard Cosell, along with Rocky Marciano, Jimmy Brown, and Les Kider. Sonny Liston is yet to come into the ring. Cassius has been in now for about 4 minutes. Sonny is now approaching the ring. Quickly, the referee tonight will be Barney Felix. Frank Freeman is your ring announcer, from whom you'll be hearing in a moment, and the judges, Gus Jacobson and Bill Lovett. We've already given you the manner in which the bout will be scored. Sonny Liston, as always, wrapped in that terry cloth towel of his over his head in kind of swami fashion, looking as malevolent and baleful as ever, but this man is a professional prize fighter, make no mistake about it. Joe Louis said today that this man could have fought anybody who ever fought, Rock. Do you agree?
Yes, it looks that way. He's really gone through the list of challenges and really has a very impressive record. He looks mighty sturdy up there.
You want to go on record now before the fight with a firm prediction as to what's going to happen, Rock?
Well, I would rather not. Anything can happen in a heavyweight fight. Of course, man for man, Liston is so much stronger, so much more experienced, and so much the better fighter. I think that if Clay can get by the first couple of rounds, maybe we'll have an interesting fight.
Incidentally, just being introduced in the ring is Luis Rodriguez, whom Rocky and I mentioned a moment ago, part of Angelo Dundee's stable. Sugar Ray Robinson is also down here. He seems to be part of the Cassius Clay entourage. Jimmy Brown, would you admit that there's been an atmosphere surrounding this heavyweight championship title event that perhaps doesn't attach to even a championship football game in your league?
Absolutely, Howard. I think I'm more nervous now than I have been in any football game. It's something altogether different. In fact, right at this moment, I'm a little afraid for Cassius Clay after seeing Liston walk into that ring.
The man can destroy you almost with a stare, can he?
Absolutely. This cherry cloth robe that he has on is a frightening-looking thing. And he seems to move very very lightly on his feet for a big man.
On the other side of the coin, Frank Freeman has just introduced Eddie Machen, now Sugar Ray Robinson. But fight fans remember when Machen won 12 rounds with Liston, successfully ran from him. And Machen looks like a tiny man, Jimmy.
Yes, he does. Eddie looks like he's ready to fight for the championship.
I just want to remind you all that you are listening to the heavyweight championship fight coverage and other top sports exclusive on the ABC Radio Network.
Probably one of the most...
There's only one sports event, and this is it. The Battle of the Heavyweights for the Championship of the World. Wild Root takes pride and pleasure in helping to bring this event to fans across the country. Wild Root, the greatest name in hairdressing for men. And Wild Root is even greater than ever now, with a great new formula and a convenient new tube. New Wild Root grooms your hair to look neat and natural. Gives you that neat and natural look that's so important to your appearance. Your hair never looks greasy when you use New Wild Root. New Wild Root has no grease in its totally new formula. It's great new formula. Try a tube of New Wild Root tomorrow. Find out how neat and natural your hair can really look. New Wild Root.
New Wild Root grooms your hair to stay neat through the day. You look so neat and natural. That's
Well, I wish you could have heard the two roars we've just heard here at Miami Beach Convention Hall. The first one for Joe Louis. No need to recount what he's meant to boxing in this country or the kind of man he is. The second for the gentleman doing his stint tonight at my right for ABC Radio, Rocky Marciano. And these two men, they talk about boxing and they talk about the things wrong with the sport. These two men represent most certainly what's been right with the sport throughout all the years. As the public address announcer continues to talk, Cassius Clay continues to shadow box. Liston continues to move his feet ever so slightly. And to bring Les Guider in now for a moment, Les somehow, and I'm not prognosticating anything, believe me, it seems a little different than before the Patterson-Liston bounce, doesn't it?
There's no comparison at all, Howard. The excitement and the questions built up about the ability or lack of same of Cassius Clay has stirred the boxing world, and you can sense it here in the auditorium tonight.
In particular, Clay continues to amaze me. The eyes look, I must confess, just a little bit different from the way I know Cassius. That may be the natural nervousness that attaches to Jimmy Brown.
And he's getting a big ovation, too.
Just been introduced. But I'll tell you this, he's amazing. This kid is really amazing, at least in his physical attitude, because you'll remember Patterson was not quite like this, without derogating Patterson in any sense.
No question about it, Howard. Now they're introducing the champion of the world. He weighed 218 today, Charles Sonny Liston.
Liston, who has just been introduced, as Les mentioned, came in at 218. You think he's a little bit heavy, Rock?
Yeah, he could be just a little bit. Maybe a couple of pounds would have been better for him.
Well, I don't know. Maybe he's a little bit heavy. Some have said he was a little pudgy around the waist, Rocky.
Howard, Cassius is sticking his nose right into Liston's face and standing on his tiptoes to make that inch and a half look like three.
Yeah, he's trying his best. The psychological warfare. They've had the referee's instructions, and now let's turn it over to Les Guider.
Thank you, Howard Cosell, and good evening, sports fans across the land. And now the questions will be answered. Liston in the white trunks with the black stripes. Clay, an inch and a half taller in the white trunks with the red stripes. Clay to our left, Liston to our right. The heavyweight championship of the world, and if it goes past the first round, there will be surprises already. Liston bobbing and weaving. Clay has been bouncing up and down, and here they come. Clay and Liston, and Liston misses a long left lead to start it off. Lands a left jab on the nose. Clay backing away, and Clay moving to his left as they said he would do. Liston tags him with a left high on the head. Clay just backing away. Clay hasn't swung a punch yet. Liston moved right after him, and now Clay sticks a left in the nose of Liston. Liston keeps moving. He's stalking his man, bobbing, weaving. Now Clay shifts and goes clockwise, then counterclockwise. Now moving to his left, bobbing, weaving. Takes a light left on the eyelid, another left on the nose by Liston. It's Clay who swung only one punch so far. Takes a hard right to the body. It hurts. And Liston moves in, but Clay tries to tie him up in mid-ring. Barney Felix breaks him. Liston landed the best punch so far. Left the body, left to the nose by Liston. Another one by Clay. And then Liston right over our ABC microphones. Misses a wild right hand. Clay moving to his left, forces Liston to miss a wild left. Then Liston missed a right to the body, and Clay keeps dancing. Clay doing thus far what he said he would do. Lands a light left to the right ear of Liston. Now it's Liston stalking, but Clay bobbing, weaving, goes in low with a light left to the body, and then backs away. Feints with his head, takes a left to the neck by Liston. Right over our microphones, Liston throws the left jab twice, both in the neck. Clay just laughs at him, backs away, bobbing, weaving. And he's inviting murder as his hands down. Then he throws a left to Liston's ear, misses a wild right hook. Missed by Clay. Clay does not seem awed by Liston up to this juncture. Liston with a light left to the nose. Clay trying to show Liston he can take his punches, forces Liston to miss another left hand. Liston has another kind of boy in there tonight than Patterson. Here's Liston missing a right to the body. And Clay lands a left to the nose and then backs away and pulls his head back as they warned him not to do, and he's doing it and getting away with it so far. Liston, light left to the head, another left to the nose. And Clay keeps moving around like a statue going in reverse, then throws a light left to the head, and then backs away again. Moves in, moves back, dances sideways, takes a left to the nose, crouches, ties up Liston. And in the first 2 minutes, it's been Cassius Clay doing what the expert said he would not get away with. Clay misses a light left, taken on the gloves by Liston. Liston now bobbing and weaving. Liston now not throwing punches, waiting for an opening. Now throws a left to the head. And Clay bounces like a wrestler off the top ropes and eludes both punches thrown by Liston. Clay with a light left to the body and a left taken on the gloves of Liston. Clay with a left to the nose and Clay with a left to the cheek. It's Clay so far. Here's Liston missing a long left lead. Backs Clay into the ropes. Liston bobs, weaves. Clay with a light left to the nose. Clay with a left and a right attack. A left and a right and another left and a right by Clay. And Liston blinked. Here's Liston hit with a right to the ear. Clay with a left and a right. Look out, Cassius. He's throwing left hand. And now Liston throws the left to the body. And it was Cassius Clay with a half a dozen assorted blows. He forced Liston to blink. Here's Liston missing a long left as Cassius backs away. Clay now a light left jab to the head. Clay with his eyes open wide. They look like doorknobs are so wide open. Here is Liston stalking him again. Takes a light left to the waist. Throws the left to the nose, and Clay backs away, keeps daring him to swing those left hands. Clay with a sharp left cross to the nose, another one to the nose, a left jab to the nose, a left to the head, all Clay, and a left to the nose by Clay. They keep fighting after the bell, and the Liston with the left thing, Liston backs Clay into his corner. The bell is rung, and they keep on fighting for 20 seconds. That's the end of round one.
Let's go back to Les Carter.
Round two. Sonny Liston did not sit down during the between rounds minute. He's anxious to get going. It's been Clay a surprise so far. Clay lands the left jab in his own corner. Backs away now, moving to his right. Instead of to his left as they thought he would do to get away from the left hand. It's Clay with left jabs and a hard left by Liston. The best punch he's landed. Knocked Clay back about 2 feet. Didn't seem to hurt him too much. Knocked him off balance. Clay looks a little more concerned after that left hand. Now Liston over in his own corner shoots two left jabs that miss. Clay ducks, forced him to miss a wild right hook. It's Liston missing more punches than he missed in the two fights with Patterson. All right, it's Clay now an inch and a half taller, jabbing lightly with the left. And then Liston throws a hard right hook that lands on the chest. As Clay backs away, a left to the body and a right to the shoulder by Liston. Right to the body by Liston. Clay apparently being hit now, forcing Clay, Liston to miss. Liston throws a left jab and Clay is taunting him in the ring. Clay lands a light left, just pecking with it. Liston bobs and weaves. He doesn't care. He's waiting for his opening. That's the impression he gives. Liston paws with the left twice. It landed once, missed once. Lands again. As Clay bobs and weaves, head feints all the time, backpedaling. Clay shoots the left and then ducks back. Takes the left to the nose, backs away. Neither man has been marked thus far. We're a third of the way through round two. Liston missed the right. Liston has yet to land the right except to the body. Here's a right landed almost on the hip by Liston. Clay with a light left jab, then backs away, moving to his right. Clay not bouncing as much as he did in the first round, but he's backing away and eluding the punches so far. A light left slap to the face by Clay. Now right over our microphones, Barney Felix referee, left to the body by Liston. A left to the body by Clay, neither one with much authority. Now Clay shifts and moves right to left. Backs into a corner, and they warn him not to do that, but he ducks and comes out without a blow being struck by Liston. Liston holding his punches for the moment, looking for the opening. Now throws a left and then back slaps at Clay, gets him up against the rope, pounds a left to the body, misses a right, then lands a left to the body, and Clay holds on, holds Liston away, and then Liston chops at him with a right hand, and Clay shoves him back. Clay at long range now, lands a light left to the cheek. It's Liston bobbing and weaving like we've never seen him do before. Misses a right, lands a high left uppercut, but it grazed the nose of Cassius Clay. Clay misses a left, throws a left, blocked by the gloves of Sonny Liston twice. Liston missed the left jab, then paused awkwardly for a moment with the left, and now he stands still, misses an overhand right. Liston missing. Clay lands a left to the nose. He just taunts him with light left. There's a left to the chin by Clay. And then Clay backs up, paws out with the left hand. We're late in the second round. Nobody has been badly hurt thus far. It's Clay bobbing and weaving more with his head than anything else as Liston shoots a straight left jab to the left ear of Clay. Didn't bother him. Clay bobbing, weaving with the head, feinting all the time, moving that head, backing away. Running, as they said he do, takes a right to the body, half block, forces Liston to swing over his head, ducks under it, and Liston and Clay tied up against the ropes. Barney Felix breaks him. Late in round two, it's Clay taking a light left to the nose. Liston started to come in from the left field, and Clay backed away. Now Clay bobs, weaves, left to the right. He's moving left to right. They're at long range. Clay with a straight left jab. Liston ducks under a left. Liston ducks under a second left. There's a right, the bell, and that's the end of round two.
First round could have gone either way. Give Liston the second round. He's punishing Clay, but Clay is gaining in confidence. That's the summary up to this point. Here is Les Kiter as we await the bell.
Round three, Howard, and 50% of the experts are wrong already. All right, a light left to the ear by Clay. Liston at long range, ducks away from a left jab, then shoots a left to Clay's head, backs Clay to the rope, throws a hard right to Clay's body. Clay bounced off the rope. Now shoots the left that misses. Misses a left and a right. Liston moves in with a left to the body. Liston bobbing, weaving, hits by a left and a right and another right hand thrown by Clay. Clay misses two lefts and then lands a left and a right and hurts Liston. A right by Clay. Liston topples. A left by Clay. He has Liston's eye cut open. Liston bleeding under both eyes. And now Liston moves in. We may be in the upset of the century. A left by Clay. A left and a right. And Liston almost topples. A left by Clay. Another left by Clay. Liston misses a wild left. Liston's eye badly cut. He shoots a light left, gets Clay against the ropes. Clay ducks and backs away. Clay forces Liston to miss a right hand, but Liston lands with the left, gets Clay into the ropes. Clay trying to hold Liston off now. Liston's eyes badly cut and he was hurt. Clay may be playing possum, we don't know. All right, Clay at long range. Liston's left eye badly cut. He throws a long left that misses. A left by Clay and a right and left by Clay in close. Liston ducked away and did not get most of the effect of those punches. Now it's Clay at long range. Clay unmarked, lands a left to the ear. Liston trying to stalk him now. Gets Clay against the ropes. Clay pushes Liston back. Now it's Clay seemingly out of breath for the minute as he ducks a left and hit by a left and a right thrown by Liston. Liston throwing caution to the winds, pounding hard. A left to the chin of Clay. Clay ducks as Liston backs Clay into Clay's own corner. Clay pushes him back. All right, now halfway through round three. Liston was cut badly and toppled once. Now Liston's coming back. Clay get hit with a left. Clay hit with another left. Ducks right in front of over our ABC microphone. Clay seemingly is out of breath for the moment. He lands a light left, misses a right as Liston ducks under him. Liston poised with the right, didn't throw it. Clay backs along the ropes. Liston right above our microphone now, ducks from a left hand. Liston straight left jab twice, once to the ear, once to the chin, knocks Clay into the ropes. Clay unmarked, but Clay being hurt to the body. Clay trying to follow up, seemingly not aggressive since he hurt Liston. Now he throws a right top of the head. Clay backs away, pulls the head back, then ducks, then hit with a left. And Liston begins to move in. Liston throws a light left, and Clay has seemingly no defense against him. As Liston pushes him up against the ropes, lands a right uppercut in close. Clay getting hurt in close. Liston has his left eye swollen shut, his right eye cut. Liston missed a right, missed a left as Clay backs away. Clay exclusively on a bicycle moving backwards now. It's Liston with a light left, tries to set him up with a left for a right and missed both of them. Throws a left to the body, a left to the ear, all by Sonny Liston. Clay backing away, Clay unmarked, but Clay seemingly has run out of breath. He forces Liston to miss a right hand. He's making Liston look very awkward. It's Clay with a straight left, exchanging left hands with Liston. Liston's eyes look like he's been in a meat grinder. Sonny Liston, both eyes cut. But he's landing on Clay now. Clay backing away. Shoots a light left jab like a kid pawing away. No effort. No strength on it. Liston throws the left, is tied up. Clay ties him up right over our ABC microphone. The bell end of round three.
Words don't make a fight. Fists do. Clay is making the fight tonight with his fists. We're surprised. So is everybody else in this arena, including the top sports writers in the nation. Here's Les.
Round four, the question, can Clay's speed hold up? That seems to be the big question now. Clay misses a light left, then lands a light left, and Liston bobbing, weaving, they fixed up his eyes pretty well. The left eye has a big mouse under it and a terrific cut over the mouse. The right eye slightly swollen, but not badly. Clay actually hurt Liston late in the third round, just before he cut his eye, and the writers behind us agree he did topple momentarily. Since then, he's come back strong, and Clay seemingly out of gas. Now let's see in this fourth round. Neither man has really swung a heavy punch in this round in the first 30 seconds. At long range, a light left jab by Clay, followed by a left jab to the nose by Clay. Liston pawing away, waiting now, waiting for an opening, standing up straight. Now he bobs and weaves, catches Clay's blows with his glove, then moves in on Clay in Clay's own corner, tries to rock him with lefts and rights, but Clay bobs, weaves, goes on the bicycle. Clay gets hit with a right hand, but he was backing away, and Barney Felix said something to Cassius Clay. Clay totally unmarked thus far. Clay with a short series of left and right combinations in close without too much punch behind him. Liston backs Clay into Liston's corner, and Clay ducks under him, ties him up. Liston works to the body with a left hand. It's in close all Liston. Clay seemingly not able to do any infighting, just holding Liston at bay. It's Clay missing a left, shooting a light left to the body. He telegraphed it. Then he takes a left to the nose, thrown by Sonny Liston. Liston, who was hurt momentarily, has come back. The left eye is bleeding again. Liston's left eye, Clay unmarked. Liston lands a left to the left ear of Clay. Clay not backing up so fast now. Takes a light right to the body, but was backing away from it. Catches most of Liston's punches on his gloves at this moment. Now it's Liston stalking his man. Clay starts to bounce and bound up and down again as he backpedals and goes onto the bicycle. Reminiscent, apparently, of Tooney's bicycle against Dempsey. Here's Clay with two lefts to the nose and a left to the neck and a left to the chin. All Cassius Clay. Not too much force, but they landed cleanly. All right, it's Clay backpedaling away, and that pulling his head back hasn't hurt him so far. Here's Liston with a sharp left to the chin, but Clay backed away as he took the full effect of the punch. Now it's Liston stalking his man. Throws a short chopping right and left to the nose, hurt Clay. Liston hit him with a combination right and then left. Now it's Liston right above our ABC microphone, backing away, letting Clay paw. Misses two left leads as Clay backs into his own corner and then side wheels away from Sonny Liston. He side-wheeled right away from Liston, and the crowd applauds that move. Now it's Liston blocking with the gloves those light left jabs thrown by Clay. A left jab by Liston that snapped his head back, but he was backing away anyway. And Sonny Clay, or rather Cassius Clay, misses a long left hook. The longest punch he's thrown, and catches Liston's left on his gloves. Liston moving in relentlessly. Clay backpedaling on the bicycle, moving left to right all the way. A left to the nose, then another one, and another one by Clay. As Liston takes him on the nose, keeps coming, throws a long left hook that Clay bobs away from. Clay on the bicycle. Can Clay hold on? Will the gas stay there? Will he run out of gas? That's the question. Left to the ear by Clay. He's buffaloed everybody so far. He ducks away from a long left thrown by Liston. Liston is yet to land a crushing blow. Here's Clay with a left to the nose at the bell. That's the end of round four.
Something's the matter with Cassius Clay. Something is the matter with Cassius Clay. As we were getting ready to start the fourth round, he is having trouble with his eyes. The bell sounds for the fifth round, correction, and he is having trouble with his eyes.
One of his trainers yelled there's something in Liston's gloves. Clay is blinking, said he can't see. Here's Liston crouching, hitting to the body, and Clay keeps blinking like he doesn't see Liston, and that will be fatal. Here's Liston throwing a left to the head, gets Clay against the rope, pounds left and rights to Clay's body, and it's Liston all the way now, left and rights to Clay's body. Clay tries to fend him off and still blinks like he can't see. Left to the top of the head by Liston, and Clay looks all done as he backs away. Liston gets him against the rope. It's all Sonny Liston, the champion now. Against the challenger is Clay, backing away almost half-heartedly from Liston. Liston's eyes both chopped up, but he's leading the damage and throwing the damage now. It's Clay blinking, backing away. Liston's left blocked by his glove. Liston has Clay in Liston's corner, misses a right chop, and side-wheeling out of there is Clay, but Clay hitting the nose with a hard left hand. Liston gets him in the corner and pounds hard to the body. Clay has been hurt now. Clay trying to fend him off, into the rope, side-wheeling away, but Liston stalks him, throws a right to the chin. Liston is close to finishing it now. He has Clay with a left to the body and a left and a right, and it's Clay only half-heartedly side-wheeling away with his gloves open in front of him. Liston paws with the left. Liston, awkward, but still throwing the dynamite. Liston stalks him, fakes with the left, faints with his head. Fakes again as side-wheeling Clay gets out of the way from that one, moving along the ropes, as he did earlier, but not as fast. Clay comes back with two left jabs. Clay, pawing away, seems to see okay now, but he catches the left top of the head. Liston with another left and a right to the chin, thrown by Clay. And by Liston, a left, hard left cross to the chin by Liston. It's Liston with a left and a right. Liston throwing the bombs, left to the head, Liston. Liston misses the left. Clay still taunting him, holding him at range with a left hand, then ducks. But Liston straightened him up with a short right chop to the chin. Liston missed the left, but Clay leans over the top rope and forces Liston to miss again. Halfway through round number five, neither man down. Liston, light left, and Clay gets hit with a left to the nose in Liston's corner, wrestles Liston down, and Liston's left eye is closing again. Although it's Liston doing all the swinging now. Clay holds him at bay with a left hand, like a wrestler, making Liston look under his glove to try and find an opening. And now, Liston is taunted by Clay's left, which he keeps pushing into his nose and blinding Liston so he can't see for the moment. He keeps that left hand open and just taps away three, four, five times. Here's Liston with a right to the body. Clay backing away and then throws a left hook. And Liston is tied up in Liston's corner by Clay. Clay walking away, almost defying Liston to hit him. And Liston trying his level best to do just that. Liston faced with the left. Stalks him, throws a hard left to the cheek of Cassius Clay, and they almost talk to each other for the moment. Clay looking at him as if to say, there, that your best punch? I took it, didn't I? All right, here's Liston now in slow motion, both men seemingly tired. Clay ducks, keeps his hands down with a right hand pawed up over his nose, and that's what Liston can't see over half the time. Here it is again, the left in the face of Liston. Not punched, just laying on his nose. The bell, the end of round five.
Now let's pause briefly for station identification.
WABC, New York.
All right, we're waiting for the bell for round six. There it is, Les Kiter.
All right, Howard, the big question, who's going to run out of gas first? They're both close. All right, both men moving at half the speed they were in the first three rounds. This is round number six, which is a shock to most experts already. Neither man down, Liston cut under both eyes, particularly the left eye. Clay is alluded all those troubles about not seeing now. His eyes are wide open like doorknobs again, and they've stopped the bleeding of Liston. All the time we've been talking, nobody has swung a punch. Here's Liston with two light left, both missed by about 6 inches. Clay lands a left, but Liston ducked under and took an eye on the forehead. Liston, not aggressive now, is hit with a right to the cheek and a left to the eye. It's Clay coming on again. Passes Clay at long range, shoots a straight left to the nose, another one. And Liston doesn't seem able to come back from it, or doesn't seem to want to at the moment. Takes to throw him a leather. He misses most of them, but a couple lay on top of the head. Swinging wild. He may be dreaming now of going on to finish Sonny. He shoots the left to the nose. It's Liston without throwing anything this round. There's a straight left by Sonny that missed. The champion of the world, Sonny Liston, harassed by Cassius Clay. Clay at long range now, not moving on the bicycle, just pulling back his head. And now he shoots a left to the air and a short right chop and a left to the head by Clay. And the big question to everybody, what's the matter with Sonny Liston? It's all Clay at the moment, and he's not doing too much, but more than Liston. Liston ducks. Liston with a left out, not throwing in the punch. He seems okay when you see him standing there, but he's not doing any punching. Here's a straight left jab that misses by Liston. Clay against the rope, but Liston, instead of moving in on him, works to the body, and Clay just side wheels away again. Now it's Clay with a light left, another light left. He almost looks like he's stalking Liston for the moment. Liston, straight up, with a left hand out, takes a light left to the nose, another left to the cheek, thrown by Cassius Clay. The challenger throws a right hand bolt, and Liston ducked away from it. Now at long range, we're midway through round number six. Convention Hall, Miami, a very tame sixth round. Clay bobbing with his head, so is Liston, and it's Liston backing up now. Clay comes in with a left and a right, neither one with much damage, but it's Liston backpedaling away, and Clay, instead of on the bicycle now, seemingly is stalking the champion. And it's Clay missing a left, landing a light right. The crowd roared, but he didn't hurt him. It's the fact that he's doing the aggressive fighting, and Liston is not. A light left misses by Clay, and it's Clay moving in, Liston backing up. Liston stands flat-footed for the moment, has the left high. It's Clay shooting a hard left inside that lands on the neck of the champion. And Liston lands a short jolting left hook, the best punch he's thrown this round. Now he takes a light left to the nose, another one thrown by Clay at long range. It's Cassius Clay jabbing with the left, another left by Clay. And all the predictors of a one-round knockout have long since seen their predictions go down the drain. All right, here's Liston right over our microphone, stalking. Just shooting a light left jab, and now Clay comes back stalking, shooting the left, and it's Liston backing up a couple of steps, then Liston with a sharp right that lands on the neck as Clay pulled his head back. Clay with a light left. Clay seemingly unmarked, seemingly unaffected by Liston's punches thus far. And the bell, and that's the end of round six.
All I can say is what Rocky Marciano has just said. This is hard to figure out as we come up to round seven. Clay looked like he had about had it coming into the fourth round. Now, wait a minute. Sonny Liston's not coming out. Sonny Liston is not coming out. He's out. The winner and the new heavyweight champion of the world is Cassius Clay. Liston going up into the ring.
All right, Howard. Sonny Liston is sitting on his stool, has not moved. Nobody said a word, but Clay was the first to realize it. Came running out of his corner, waving his arms, and now the march is on as Clay continues to climb all over the ring, waving his arms.
I am the greatest. Cassius, come here. I am the greatest. Cassius, you are the king. I am the greatest. I'm the king of the world. Tell the truth,
Cassius. Get that.
I have upset the world. Give me justice.
You're the king of the
world.
Did
you ever believe it would happen this way? I told you. If you want to go to heaven, I get him in seven. I am the king.
King of the ring.
I am the king.
The gold, not me.
I am the king.
What made him so easy for you?
Because I'm too fast. He was scared.
Who gave you your plan, Angie Dundee?
No, myself.
Was there any single point where you thought you had it?
I thought I had him in the first round.
What happened to your eyes coming into the fourth?
He had an ornament on his head and his gloves. I couldn't see all that round.
And yet you survived.
Almighty God was with me.
Did he ever hurt you, Cassius?
Almighty God was with me.
Did he ever hurt you?
No, he never hurt me. I took his best punches and I couldn't see.
Cassius, my congratulations to you. Shoot over to Steve. Let go of the mic, Cassius.
Come here, Cassius. Cassius, wait a minute.
And a scene of absolute bedlam in this ring. The unbelievable has happened. We're now going over to Sonny Liston, whom we respect.
What makes him so good?
He may not want to talk.
If I won, it was going to be a fix. But it's not no fix with his eyes closed.
It's not closed.
That wasn't no fix.
It is not closed.
I didn't stop it. I want everybody to
bow with shoulder.
I am the greatest.
Willie Haddish, Sonny's trainer.
I am the king.
The winner.
You, of course, Willie, have a return clause. Return the clause in your contract.
contract, don't you?
I don't know about that, Jeff. Let's talk with Jack Nylon about this.
All right, we'll move over to Jack Nylon. Sonny, I hate to bother you in a moment like this, but you've been a great champion, and you fought tonight. Would you tell us in your own words exactly what happened, Sonny?
My shoulder feel like it's broke.
Could you come a little closer, Sonny? I hate to trouble you.
My shoulder feel like it's broke. I don't know what's wrong with it.
When did it happen, Sonny?
In the first round. I hit him with a, hit at him with a left hook and he blocked it with his arm.
Sonny, did he ever, apart from the shoulder break that you yourself suffered, did he ever hurt you?
No, he did. Never did.
And I take it as I talk to Jack Nylon surrounding Sonny right now that there'll be a return match, Jack?
Well, if they'll give it to us.
You don't have a clause?
No.
Nothing to that effect?
Nothing. We have nothing. Where's the robe at? Get the robe.
All right, they're putting the robe on Sonny Liston right now. Sonny, if given another shot at this boy, who has been so amazing, do you think you can do to him what you did to Patterson if given another shot?
I don't know. I have to think about it.
Thank you, Sonny, and good luck to you anyway. That's the story as we have it now in this incredible ring. You have heard the possibility that there may be no return match. They are booing Sonny Liston. You've heard the story of his shoulder, what he says happened to it. Cassius is standing in the ring. He's taking the bows. Joe Louis suddenly next to him, and it was Joe who on the pre-fight show said Liston could fight anybody in any era. This is, without question, no need to pour it on, one of the astonishing upsets in the whole chronicle of boxing. With that, we're going to leave for the dressing room. We're going to turn it over to Les Kiter at ringside.
Liston's shoulder went out. He did not continue. Winner by a TKO in the seventh round.
Thank you, Howard Cosell.
Cassius Clay.
Playback of the final round. Howard will now rush back to the champion's dressing room as we continue our fight coverage exclusive on the ABC radio network. What was formerly ringside, no longer, because our table went the way of Sonny Liston tonight. The table collapsed under us as some of the police and fans piled into the ring. It would take us a long time to give you a recapping exactly and succinctly what happened. Suffice it to say, it was a fight that shocked everybody. It was Cassius Clay, apparently unaffected by a single punch that Sonny Liston threw from the start of the first round. It was a Cassius Clay who taunted Liston almost the way he did before the fight. Everybody said this was his moment of truth, that all the nonsense would go out the window. Well, if it went out the window, we saw quite a bit of it in the ring, particularly in the fourth, fifth, and sixth rounds, when after Liston had been badly cut under the eye in round three and obviously toppled at one stage just before his eyes were cut, he then came on strong. And it was Liston coming back, and in the fourth round, after the cut eye, it appeared to us that Cassius Clay had shot his wad, as they say. He seemingly was running out of gas, and then came the bell for the fifth round, and it looked like we might not even have a fifth round, as Cassius Clay, emerging from his corner, claimed he couldn't see. And one of his handlers hollered, "There's something on Liston's gloves." And as Liston went after an apparently defenseless Clay, Cassius sidewheeled along the ropes, ducked, bobbed, weaved, and Sonny Liston just could not land any payoff punches. And then it was that Cassius Clay, seemingly getting more confidence, came roaring back in the fifth and sixth rounds. And it was now Clay doing the punching. Clay with his left hand open wide, the glove on the nose of Liston, preventing Liston from seeing where his chin was. And he continued to taunt Sonny around the ring in the fifth and sixth rounds. Liston became the big puzzle then. Everybody began to wonder, what's the matter with a champion? With Clay obviously running out of gas, obviously losing his speed, having trouble seeing because of the claim they made that there was something on the glove, and with all that going for him, Sonny Liston never once attacked and moved after him as if to finish him. And then it was that Clay turned the tables and came roaring back. And Clay, all through the sixth round, began throwing combination lefts and rights, most of them not landing, but nevertheless, he was the only one doing any swinging. Liston, as Rocky Marciano sat here, couldn't seem to understand what was the matter with Sonny Liston. And Clay then in the sixth round with that left hand in Sonny's nose, just sort of holding him at bay, taunting him, and the nonsense they said we wouldn't see, we did see. The bell rang for round seven, and everybody seemed puzzled as to what was going on. Everybody but one man. Clay knew immediately that Liston was not coming out because he came dancing out of his corner with his hands up in the air, and before anybody realized what would happen, we looked at Liston, and he was sitting on his stool, and the official word is he hurt his shoulder and could not go on. As we promised you on ABC all day long and earlier tonight, we're going to have a real expert to talk about the fight. We thought we were going to have an expert to talk about a first or second round knockout, but instead, we've never been so happy to see anybody as we are now to see the guy they claim to be the greatest fighter pound for pound of all time. And we're going to bring him on right after we bring you this special replay. Ray Sugar Robinson will be our guest, but first we're going to play back the tape of that last round in just a moment.
That I really am happy about the showing that Cassius made. He made a very clever, fought a very clever fight, and more of the matador and the bull fight, and I think it proved successful for him.
We are sitting at ringside, Les Kiter with Sugar Ray Robinson, and Ray, looking at it from the Cassius Clay standpoint, at no time tonight did he appear to us to be in any serious trouble, although it looked after he had hurt Liston in the third round and cut him, that he sort of ran out of gas for a while, but he got his second win when he realized Liston couldn't hurt him, and it was Clay from then on.
That's right. I looked at it the same way. After the third round, he seemed to catch his second win, and he went on to I think that Cassius made a very surprising to most people, but very good showing. I think he has the great potential for a heavyweight champion, and I wish the fella the best of everything.
Ray, you know, it's strange in this world of ours. You are probably one of the most modest athletes America has ever had in any sport. Cassius Clay is something short of that because Clay claims and always has that he's the greatest. But it's unusual in sports when somebody can say he's going to do something and then go right in against all the experts and do just that.
Champion. More power.
That's clear the ring, please.
Thank you, Sugar Ray Robinson. Here we are at ringside, and with us now the one and only Brown Bomber himself, one of the most beloved men of all time in sports, Joe Louis. And Joe, first from the Cassius Clay standpoint, were you surprised, and what do you think was the difference tonight?
Well, I was surprised, quite naturally. I think everybody in the building was surprised. But nevertheless, Clay did put up a good fight, and I've been telling everybody that I thought that Clay was better, much better than one thought it would be because he was a natural heavyweight. But I like to say that Liston did throw his left shoulder out of whack, and the only way around he threw it out in, but I still think that he was losing the fight.
Let me ask you this, Joe. It's official now that he threw his shoulder out. Would he have won, Clay, had his Liston gone the distance?
Well, the way the fight was going, I don't think he would have won. But I don't think he would have won the way the fight was going.
Fine. Thank you very much, Joe Louis. And now we swing to Howard Cosell.
We're standing here in a strangely quiet winner's dressing room, primarily because Cassius Clay hasn't arrived. A quick recap. Bill McDonald, the man who stood up for this bout, who put up the guarantee, just said the operation was successful, the patient died, meaning he took a financial beating on the fight, but that it was a great fight with the unexpected result. Now, the real shock of this fight is what many of the great nation's reporters are standing around me still don't really know. That Liston contends that his shoulder was damaged, his left shoulder, at the very beginning of the fight. That this was why his punches seemed to lack the authority, particularly the left, that normally attaches to them, or at least did against Floyd Patterson. I'm standing with Dick Young of the New York Daily News. You can't believe it, can you, Dick?
Well, it was a shocker, I'll say that. But you learn to expect most anything in fights.
What about Liston's performance?
Well, he was just a little too anxious, I think.
Liston anxious?
Yeah, the way he chased Clay all over the ring at the start, I think he played right into Clay's hands.
You think that Liston was subjected to, psychologically, to Clay's talk?
No, I don't think it was the talk. I think that just the actions, the taunting actions of Clay, as he, of Clay as he backed up and bobbed and weaved from side to side as he ran. I think the talk might have something to do with it. But
six rounds.
More it was the actions immediately in the ring.
Did Liston impress you? Forgive me for breaking in. This is the key question. Is having hurt that shoulder in the very first round, as he told me in the ring?
Well, that's what I was about to refer to. If it happened, I don't doubt that it happened, but I doubt that it happened in the first round based on what I saw in ensuing action. In the third round, for instance, after his eye was cut, I have a note here that he staggered Clay with a left hook late in the third round. Now, I don't think you can do that with a dislocated shoulder.
So you think perhaps the injury is overrated? That the defeat, do you think Liston was out of condition?
Well, he wasn't in condition to do as much chasing as he did. I think he overextended himself. And there was a time late in the fifth round, or during the fifth round, when Clay was blinking. You know, when Clay had had this
He claimed that Liston had liniment on his gloves.
No, it seemed to come from a sponge between the rounds. His handler, Budini, I believe it was using a sponge on his face, and the lime water or whatever it was got into his eye, because it was about 5 seconds before the start of the sixth round. He bolted up off his stool and pushed that sponge away as though he was saying, get away from me with that thing. And then the bell rang immediately, and he was blinking as he retreated around the ring.
This is entirely true, but Clay did claim that Liston's handlers had put liniment on his gloves in the ring.
He's a very distrustful person, I'm afraid.
You said it, Dick Young of the New York Daily News. I didn't. As we look around in this dressing room, which now becomes more and more filled, we still haven't gotten sight of Cassius Clay, who has yet to come back here. Dan Parker, the famed boxing writer of the New York Daily Mirror, coming in, of the New York Journal American. The Mirror unfortunately expired. Frank Gibbons of the Cleveland Press, and many others. But no word from the King. And until the King comes in here, we're going to give it back to Les Kider at ringside, as the press continues to blink its eyes at what happened here tonight when Liston failed to come out for the seventh round. Here is Les Kider.
We're back at ringside, Les Kider, after the Cassius Clay victory in what will have to be called one of the greatest upsets of the last decade. Cassius Clay tonight moves alongside Gene Tunney, James J. Braddock, Ingemar Johansson, and Jersey Joe Walcott. Four men who went into the ring better than 5-1 underdogs and won the heavyweight crown. And tonight, add the name of Cassius Clay. As we sit back in reflection here at ringside with a preliminary fight going on after the main event, with our table torn apart by the police and by enthusiastic fans who climbed and clambered into the ring, the guy who's been telling the world he's the greatest might have fallen a little short of that tonight, but he took a long step in that direction. We'd like to express our appreciation to Butch Reiber of WTVN ABC in Columbus, Ohio, for bringing Sugar Ray Robinson over to us. And now I'm going to do something I have never done before on a fight broadcast, and that is read a quote that I got from a newspaper in Cincinnati a month ago. Pat Harmon, the famed baseball writer, had this to say. I kept it just in case, and this is one of those times it happened. Said Pat Harmon a month ago in Cincinnati, there's a familiar old graveyard for boxing experts who discount underdogs in heavyweight championship fights. We'll be back right now to Howard Cosell and the new heavyweight champion.
All right, we're back now in Cassius Clay's dressing room. Cassius about to come in. I'm with Angie Dundee, the trainer of Cassius Clay. Was it your strategy that won this bout, Angie?
No, it was Cassius Clay's style that licked him. I told you after the go, he had the perfect style to lick Liston. Nobody saw it. He outgunned the guy, outsmarted him, outpunched the guy. He just had the perfect style to lick Liston.
This means then that Liston was never a great fighter, but an overrated one in your opinion.
I wouldn't say that. No, I don't want to underrate Liston. I just say Cassius Clay could lick him any day in a week. I fought this right along. Nobody believed me. Everybody said it was a mismatch, a disgrace. And they picked him in and he was going to knock him out. It was disgraceful.
Liston says he hurt his shoulder in the early going. That's what beat him.
He got knocked out anyhow. Don't make no difference. He got knocked out later in 11 or 12, I said. We just got a little earlier with the shoulder break. That's all.
What was the inside story on Cassius's eyes?
They seen the guy got some dirt in him. I don't know where it came from or anything, but he got some dirt in him, and he couldn't see.
Uh-huh.
So he went the whole round without being able to see properly, but he got through the round and didn't throw a punch.
I got to tell you this, Angie. You've been a great trainer for a lot of years.
Thank you.
You had your biggest one tonight.
Thank you. That's a heavyweight champion.
All right, now let's try and pick up the press conference with Cassius Clay.
The whole place is burning. You saw me. I couldn't throw a punch, and I still got away. I left him so bad he had to go to the hospital, and I'm still pretty. What you gonna say about that, huh? I don't have a mark.
He's the greatest.
I watched Sugar Ray Robinson and Jake LaMotta for 3 months. That's what I was at. Same point. It wasn't for Sugar Ray Robinson and Bo Dini. I got Bo Dini with me. He was with Sugar Ray for 10 years. I've been having the best of training. The bar couldn't hurt me. The bar couldn't even get a good leg on him. Put him in the hospital. He's never been stopped. He's never been well. Oh, I'm so grateful. Oh, I'm so grateful. Oh, I shook up. And what makes it so good, all these hypocrites, you can't call it a fix. You can't call it a fix because I didn't stop the fight. The doctors had to stop it. Oh, I'm so pretty. I shook up the world. Man, I'm through talking. Man, you write the result.
Back to the microphone, Cassius. All of you reporters, some questions.
All of you reporters made it hard on this one. Never write about me like that. Never make me 6-1. You just make me angry. Never make me no underdog. And never talk about who's going to stop me. Because ain't nobody going to stop me. Not a heavyweight in the world fast enough to stop me. Liston's one of the powerfulest in the world, and he looked like a baby. I held my hands down here and just played with him. I just played with him. Oh, I shook all of you. What? Do you want a rematch? Well, if he wants a rematch, he can have it. But I bet you one thing, the public ain't going to want it. Yeah, he's got to get up. Oh, I whooped him so bad. Wasn't that good? I'm gonna show you how slick reporters are. Who's the greatest? You notice they don't say nothing. No justice whatsoever. No justice.
Don't even
want to give me justice.
Who you gonna fight?
Who you gonna fight?
Tell me.
I'm revealing all of you. Who's the greatest? I give him one more chance. Who's the greatest?
Who you gonna fight?
All right. I'll fight. I won't. Everybody. Oh man. Oh. Don't nobody want the public. Everybody's talking now. Don't nobody want me. Don't nothing with a fool want to fight me. And the public know you can't pick a man in the world to whoop me. I want Eddie Machen. I want Doug Jones. Sonny looked like an amateur so bad until he's got to work his way back up.
That's it.
I'll fight anybody the public want me to fight. I'm not ducking and dodging. I'm glad. I work 8 rounds a day at the weigh-in. I burn so much energy cutting up. I'm so great. And I'm still great. Champs ain't made. Champs are born. Y'all are born.
Okay. How soon will you give him a return?
Okay. In 2 months. He can have a return in 3 months.
Cassius Clay is now beginning to leave the dressing room, surrounded by his admirers and the man with the cane, Bo Dini, some call him, others call him Bondini, and in many months nobody's ever known his real name. But Cassius is shouting, "I am the king."
And indeed, he is the king. Nobody really believes it. Not anybody. Not the denizens of the sporting press, the great veterans around the nation who've covered the boxing beat for so many years. But they've got to acknowledge the fact, and they've got to write their stories. This story has been presented in sound. We're in Cassius Clay's dressing room, and we're going to send it right back to ringside for the wrap-up from Les Kiter.
Back at ringside at Convention Hall, Miami Beach, Florida, where tonight history was written, and we have the underdog who did it, and as you just heard him, he's still nonstop, whether it's boxing or whether it's talking. He does them both pretty well. Seventh round. How do you anticipate we'll make an expert on top of an expert? You had seven rounds to look back on. What would have happened the rest of the fight?
I think Clay would have won the fight. I think when Mr. Clay got through the third round that Mr. Clay was going to win the fight.
Well, you echo our feelings, and Joe Louis and Ray Robinson, everybody we've talked to, felt that Clay was coming on stronger and stronger.
I believe that, Les, but I must say one thing, Les. I didn't think Mr. Clay was going to be around to answer the bell for the fourth round. I must be honest about that.
Well, most of the fellows felt the same as you did. In fact, when the bell rang for the third round, we said 50% of the experts are down the drain already.
Well, Les, as you know, when he won the fight, his father and mother could not get in the ring.
Right.
They came over to ringside, and they finally got Clay over, and Clay looked at his mother and says, Mom, didn't I tell you I was the greatest? Here I am, the champion of the world. What do you think now?
Well, you know, it's going to be pretty hard for anybody to argue with him. He said all the experts, you sports writers, don't dare put me in an underdog at another fight. But that brings up this very good question, I'm sure, for our listeners everywhere. And then, Pete, we'll let you get back to the typewriter, and I thank you for taking time out to come over and chat with us on ABC. The question, where do we go now? Is there an automatic Liston Clay rematch? And if so, what happened?
Lance, I don't believe it's automatic, but I can tell you this. They have here tonight the chairman of the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission, the deputy chairman, and they almost have a promise to Liston that his next fight will be in Philadelphia, whereas you know Les, he started. They want him back there for one more fight.
We'll see you back home, Pete. Thank you very much. Leo Peterson, sports editor of United Press International. Now we go back briefly to the article by Pat Harmon in Cincinnati, and if he's listening, he's the most shocked man in the country that we're quoting him. He said this in his column a month ago. I like Clay's chances of knocking off the overrated Liston. He has the style and confidence to give a good account of himself. Clay is a pretty good boxer and a pretty good puncher who moves around quite a bit, and unlike Patterson, moves around and should be an elusive target for the champion. This kind of strategy could prove Liston's undoing. By dancing and prancing out of reach, Cassius could humiliate the title holder, and while it might be a relishing sight, it would extend Liston and bring him out in the open. At least that was one man's prediction, Pat Harmon in Cincinnati. We are at ringside in Convention Hall, Miami Beach, with the ABC coverage of the fight for the heavyweight championship of the world. Brought to you by the City Service Oil Company and its dealers in 37 states and Canada. Known to millions of motorists for big gallon gasoline, quality alone makes it big. And by Pepsi-Cola with a sparkling light taste that's so inviting, so clean. Now it's Pepsi for those who think young. And by the incredible new Schick stainless steel blade. The blade that shaved the 15 barbers in city after city countrywide. Schick stainless steel blade's consistent quality. And by new Wild Root, the totally new hairdressing in a new tube. Grooms your hair to look neat and natural, never greasy. This is Les Kiter saying goodbye for Howard Cosell and myself. The program was produced for ABC Radio by Maury Bencoyle and directed by Rick Layton. Associate producer, Peter Callison.
Sonny Liston were the sports pundits who picked him to win. And now we'll hear from one of those losers, Frank Gifford. What's your alibi, Frank? Strained key in your typewriter?
No alibi, Jim. I was wrong, but I've never been in such good company. And I think the entire sports world is just starting to realize that what they saw or heard or read about last night is really true. Cassius Marcellus Clay is the new heavyweight champion of the world, and it became official tonight when the Miami Boxing Commission released the fighters' purses after a medical examination of ex-champion Sonny Liston's shoulder. Apparently the commission felt the injury to Liston was severe enough that he really couldn't come out for that seventh round. However, that feeling wasn't shared by the many fight greats who were on hand and seemed to hang around, expressing almost unbelief over the way the fight ended. It just seemed impossible that Liston, who had fought six rounds with a broken jaw against Marty Marshall in 1954, would let his title go while sitting in his corner. But end it did, and for Clay, it was an opportunity to strike back at all the people, myself included, who had taken him so lightly. As a matter of fact, the victor didn't even bother showering before appearing in the press room to demand his spoils. In this case, open apologies from the members of the Fourth Estate.
Ask Lake reporters off. Who's the greatest?
Who are you going to fight next?
Who are you going to fight next?
Who's the greatest? You notice they don't say nothing. No justice. No justice whatsoever. No justice.
They don't want you.
Don't even want to give me justice.
Who are you going to fight?
Who are you going to fight?
Tell me. I'm revealing all of you. Who's the greatest? I'll give you one more chance. Who's the greatest?
You are.
All right.
You know, I felt like he was looking right at me. One hockey score tonight, the league-leading Montreal.
Says tonight, it is completely satisfied that Sonny Liston suffered what is called an honest injury, which kept him from continuing his engagement with Cassius Clay last night in the title fight. Liston's share of the live gate has been released to him. Here's the word from one of the examining doctors, Alexander Robbins of the Miami Beach Boxing Commission.
Playing happened in the middle of the first round. He threw a left hook and felt a snap in his left arm.
You examined him at the end of the sixth round. Did it look to you like he it was pretty bad shape?
Yes,
then?
Yes. His arm felt like he was carrying a heavy pail of water. I mean, that's how he explained it.
And when you looked at the arm, was it in pretty bad shape in the ring at that time?
Yes,
and
yes.
You feel he was unable to continue? And
yes, he was unable to abduct his arm.
And as of this examination with the other eight doctors, it is definitely
bad
shape.
Yes, he sustained
shape.
That injury.
And there's no doubt in your mind
about
that the fight should have been stopped.
No doubt in my mind about that.